I'm going to help all of you to understand the genesis of identity and what is really we, what is it out of which we are made, what's the stuff out of which we are made. All right, now we will listen. How many of you are very clear? There is so much confusion, conflict, contradiction inside you. Raise your hand. So now I will move to the solution. First of all, let us understand our genesis of identity. Means, what are we? How we are made up? Let me give you a simple diagram. It is just a human body I am trying to draw. Listen, please understand, what you think about you inside you is inner image. Please understand. What you think about you inside you is inner image. Second, how you show you to others, these are all others. How you show you to others, usually through words only you try to show. That's why I am putting in the mouth. How you show you to others, that is outer image. How you think of you inside you, as you, is inner image. Usually this will be, oh God, whatever I touch never gets through, whatever I touch never goes through, I don't know what I am doing, I don't know. Constantly thinking lower than what is. Usually that is the way the inner image is built. Listen, whatever you think about you inside you is inner image. How you show you to the others, to the outer world, that is outer image. And what others think of you, that is others image. Others image. See, what others think of you. Never believe what they tell you directly. How to find out what others believe about you, you know, others' image. What they tell your friend and tell your friend not to tell you. Whatever has been told to your friend and then they tell the friend, don't tell Swami. Don't tell you. That is others' image. How many of you understand what I am saying? Others' image. What others think of you, that is others' image. Fourth, what you think about the world and others, that is life image. What you think about others and life, life image. Please understand this four word. Whatever you think about you inside you as you, inner image. How you show you to others, outer image. How others perceive you, others image. How you perceive others and world is life image. How many of you are clear about these four words? Raise your hand. If you are not clear, raise your hand. I'll repeat once more. Yes. Keep your hands up. Listen. Please listen. I'm talking to all of you. What you think as you inside you is inner image. how you show you to others, outer image. How others perceive you, that is others' image. How you perceive others and life is life image. Now clear? My inner image, when I look inside and try to see what I am, I see a vast emptiness, a boundaryless space. You can call it as emptiness or completion, purna or shunya, void or fulfillment, whatever you can call, a vast emptiness. That's all I feel about me. And what is my outer image? I am very clear. I am an incarnation to transmit that experience to all of you. That's all. That is my outer image. Others' image. How people perceive me. You can, that is your freedom. You can perceive me in any way you want. For example, I declare I am here to give you the enlightenment experience. But you have the right to ask me to heal your knees. You can say, give me a boon to get a job. Bless me to heal me. You have a right, because whatever you ask is within the purview of my declaration. See, what I am saying, I am here to transmit that experience to you. Then you always have the right within that purview to ask me, please heal me, or please give me this boon, or bless me for this to happen. All that you have a right. Within my declaration, whatever you ask, your image, your expectation about me, your perception, I am responsible to fulfill it. Understand? Either I have to directly give it as a boon from my energy, or I should prepare you to receive it and transmit. Either I should directly transmit. If you are not able to receive, I should prepare you and transmit. But I am responsible for whatever you expect from me within this purview. How many of you understand what I am saying? So I am responsible for your image, your perception about me within my declared purview. I am declaring, I am here to transmit that vastness, that experience which I am carrying, which I call enlightenment. You can call it as in any name, enlightenment, no mind state, living Advaita, super conscious state, whatever word you want, you can use God consciousness. You can use any number of words, Brahman, Atman, Paramatman, whatever word you want, you can use. That experience which I am carrying, I am here to transmit that. But healing your knee pain, headache, completing your relationship issues, bringing you peace, contentment, all these are within that purview. How many of you understand what I am saying? All this comes inside my declared purview. What I am saying? I am saying, I am here to transmit that experience to all of you. That's all is my declaration. So whether you want your headache to be healed or hair to grow long, our knee pain to be healed, have the peaceful life, peaceful relationship, contentment in your life, all this, if you expect from me, I am responsible for it. Understand? There's a big difference between what is my responsibility for your expectation from me and what is not. How many of you understand this difference? This is the same thing applies in your life also. If you declare to somebody, I am your husband or I am your wife, so whatever that person can expect from a husband or wife, you become responsible. How many of you understand what I am saying? So the moment you say, no, you are no more my husband, you are no more my wife, then you are no more responsible. You are responsible for all your declared relationships. You are responsible for your declarations. That is what is other's image. And life image. My life image. My image about the life and others. The whole world is here to celebrate with me. That's all. The whole world is here to celebrate with me. This is my four image I have clearly described. Now, I want you to sit and spend a little time with you. What is exactly the inner image you are having now? Pen down. Please understand. What is now you have? Pen down that. Later on, I will guide you to create the best inner image. That is second. Now it is like a stock taking. Whatever is in the godown, please note down. Listen. Describe all the words and statements you use to describe yourself. The qualities that you believe are part of your internal image, inner image. For example, I am lazy, whatever you are having. This is called mamakara in Sanskrit. The next, how you show yourself to the outer world, ahankara. Third, others image, anyakara. Fourth, life image, swanyakara. Please pen down. First, whatever you have, pen down. Then we will move to the next. First, answer these four questions.
Thank you.
Listen, how many of you found out the inner image is always lower than what you are? Raise your hand. Outer image is always more than what you are. Raise your hand, let me see. How many of you found out the outer image is always more than what you are? Raise your hand. How many of you found out the other's image and life image are completely opposite? What others look at you and what you look at the world, both are completely opposite. Raise your hand.